boosted the basketball non-conference schedule. Just maybe talk about that a little bit, and then how much would you like to get some of those games at Assembly Hall at some point?
Yeah, I'm not so sure we've really boosted the schedule that much in a deliberate way. Some of the RPI impact really follows the vagaries of different teams being kind of up and down. So I don't really subscribe to the theory that that our non-conference schedule in particular hurt us in terms of postseason play. For example, I think we didn't get in the postseason because we finished too low in the Big Ten, and that's really irrelevant to the non-conference schedule. Having said that, we're trying to be more mindful of having at least one really what I call marquee non-conference game in Assembly Hall, and the whole conclusion, or at least intermittent suspension of the Kentucky series, has made it more challenging to get that rhythm. But this year, we've really got that back. First with our ACC game being in Bloomington with Pitt, and then we have SMU in Bloomington as well, for a couple good non-conference games. And we've always had pretty quality neutral court games. We're staying with that this year, going to Madison Square Garden twice, which I think will be cool, playing quality opponents there. So for better or worse, I can't say to you that was some mastermind idea to beef up our schedule. I don't think it really was. I think in general parameters, this is pretty consistent with what we've been trying to do year in and year out.
What worked out better this time? I guess, you know, obviously last year there was a lot of other things kind of committed for this year, but, you know, what sort of allowed this year to open up a lot of other things?
Right. Well, you know, the ACC, the Big Ten ACC challenge being home helps, and then we knew and couldn't really say about the Gavitt game series coming up, and so our master plan for the last 18 months or so had been to get the Gavitt games and the ACC challenge rotating in and out of Bloomington, so we always had one of those teams, which is almost by definition a marquee game. And then we kind of stumbled into the SMU game, which is great, and Larry and Tom are really close, and that's kind of neat to have him come back. So we did have a method to our madness. It just didn't kick in as soon as we thought.
And great question, because they've actually changed our rules where we can have a little bit more interaction with our team in the summer than we in years past could. So it used to be just strength coaches, you know, it was kind of that voluntary mode where you kind of had them there and whatnot. It's now getting to, we have an 8-week period that we can work with our team. We have some rules with legislation that says you have to be so many hours passed per year and certain GPA, or you must be enrolled in a summer session. So what we did, our May, you know, we got these 4-week sessions and 6-week sessions. I like to give the guys a little bit of an academic break. So unless someone really wanted to be in school, and we've got all our guys in great academic shape going to summer, so we're not sitting here sweating bullets of, are you going to be, you know, you got to pass so many classes or your GPA. We're sitting really good academically as a team. So May was kind of, if you want to go home, take a little break. Now, if I do the 8 weeks starting in June, it goes up to the first day of practice. And you kind of want to give them a little time right before practice to kind of get a little fresh. You don't want to just be running them and running them and running them. By the way, now we practice tomorrow. So we always like to have one of those, what we call a discretionary off week, kind of right before the camp starts. So we actually started our workout program Monday. Summer school will start next Monday. So this first week we're in old school voluntary because I don't have everybody in summer school. And the freshmen will show up next Monday. Next Monday, we then go, Zach, into a 7-week period, and coaches can be a part of, like, winter. I can go to the weight room. I can be at a running workout if I choose to. I'm allowed meeting time up to a 2-hour limit, which I think 2 hours is maybe even too long in summer because, you know, you don't want to sit, you know, it's maybe good for freshmen, but for returners, you don't.